As I let go of the rope, I had no idea this was gonna turn into one of the most terrifying waves of my life. I was very confident this was gonna be really easy to ride. It didn't look that big. I was just gonna cruise. I was gonna go to the bottom, maybe set up for a little barrel. What I didn't realize, and what makes Nazare one of the wildest waves ever, is that these waves will just grow out of nowhere. You think you're towing into like a 10-foot wave, and all of a sudden it'll just explode into a 50-foot monster. So I didn't even realize this as I'm dropping in. I only realized it when I got to the bottom, burned all my speed. I had no speed left because I was expecting to look back and see a small wave. And I just look up at like 50 feet of vertical water, and it's looking like it's gonna fall directly on top of me. And at this point, my body just went into survival mode where I'm like, okay, just get ready for the craziest impact of your life. Like, I'm getting like flashes of that horrible Andrew Cotton wipeout. The lip landed on top of him and he broke his back. Like, if this thing lands on me, it's gonna split me in half like a twig. And all of a sudden, I just hear just like the most blood-curdling loud crack of a sound I've ever heard. This lip had landed 2 feet behind me and was just so absurdly loud. I never knew how loud the wave can be. All I could see is white. I'm just going straight. I'm just like waiting for this thing to take me out. But it was super tricky because all that force almost felt like it pushed me forward a little bit. And all of a sudden I just came out just in complete shock. And I was just like, wow, I didn't expect that to happen. I was expecting in this moment I would be underwater fighting for my life. But all of a sudden I'm just totally cruising. It was just one of those very, very lucky situations, and it could have gone so bad if I was literally 2 feet farther back. So it was definitely the luckiest big wave I've ever ridden.